Oh, you weren't even looking at the cool wizard.
Wait, do it again.
No, it's already gone.
How?
Come in and sit down.
There, that's Erasmus, by the way.
Fenris, our guest has arrived.
This looks very familiar.
Cheese, please!
Oh, no.
I finally have an excuse to use the terrible Patrick Stewart.
No, it's a rat, not a mouse. Ha!
Well, still.
When did I see this previously?
I don't know. Maybe you've randomly walked in.
Wasn't
me
there something
this.
Very similar to this in King's Quest 3?
Well, there's an old wizard.
Yeah, don't we
kill
walk
in- him?
No, I mean in King's Quest 3.
Yeah. Mananan is the old wizard in King's Quest 3.
In 3?
Yeah. Do you know what time it is when Otto walks through your door?
No, 4. In King's Quest 4.
Do you know what time it is when Otto walks through your door?
Time yes, to buy a new door.
Time to get a new door!
In King's Quest 4, I don't think there's anything. I'm trying to think.
Because I've seen this scene before.
Well, it wasn't in King's Quest 4.
Some, like, the setup looks exactly... Anyway, go ahead.
Whatever. Okay, so this is Erasmus.
I'm a wizard of some renown.
I'm a wizard of some kind.
What am I? When am I some sort of object?
Make it stop.
Am I invisible or something? Did you talk about me behind my back in front of my face? Sheesh, no respect. No regard, either.
It's hard to take anyone very seriously. That's my new Erasmus voice. Who wears such a ridiculous hat?
Uh-oh, I missed the joke. But the punchline is... Big purple Ungifar, lich dinge eaters.
There you go, chat. Look that up. Ungifar, lich dinge eaters. Oh, it's too late.
That purple Ungifar, lich dinge eaters are all too common in the forest these days.
There it is again, chat. Look it up.
I don't know what the joke was. Now I'm kind of sad because that's the most random punchline ever.
Ungifar, lich.
Anyway, this guy can teach you magic.
If magic be the loot of life, play on.
The quote was music, not magic. It was food, not loot.
Well, it's like you and me.
Which one's the rat and which one's the wizard?
Oh, it depends on the subject matter.
How about magic makes the world go round?
Money makes the world go round.
Oh. Very well, then. To put it in my own words, magic is the essence and the soul of life and the wizard is a poet.
Actually, it was Merlin who said that first, but he used the term magician, not wizard.
What are you, Wikipedia? Shut up, you stupid rat! Fenris, there are times you look better as newts.
Why is that?
Because newts can't talk!
I get the joke.
Neither can most rats.
Well, there's your banter.
I do like banter.
Ooh. Let's talk about Baba Yaga.
Baba Yaga's good at curses and shape-changing spells. She has a nasty temper and doesn't believe in safe hex.
Oh my goodness.
So it's best to stay on her good side. Fortunately, she doesn't have a good side. You have to watch her. She cheats at cards.
So do you!
This is why nobody plays cards in the Adventurers Guild anymore. See? See, we're tying this all together.
I see.
She started first. Besides, I want to get it, but whatever. Shame's too built.
So here's the thing with Erasmus. I think, yeah, you asked him about curses.
The curse Baba Yaga played upon Baron von Spielberg, blah, blah, blah.
Upon von Spielberg, this is the actual curse. Upon von Spielberg and all his clan, this the curse I now demand. What I will shall come full measure, so shall ye lose all that ye treasure. Of course, the problem that for every curse there's an equal and opposite counter curse.
Ooh.
So this is important, because this will actually tell us what our actual goal is, the counter curse. Counter curse is a curse for, or is a cure for a curse. The counter curse for the curse of the Baron goes like this. Pay attention. Come a hero from the east. We've come from the east. That's already happened.
That's us.
Free the man from in the beast. That's one thing we have to do.
Bring the child from out the band.
That's something we have to do.
And drive the cursor from the land.
That's the last thing we have to do.
So to break the curse, the hero must get rid of Baba Yaga in addition to all the other things. It does not reflect well on Baba Yaga.
Nothing reflects well upon that ogress. She has a face that would break anything but a magic mirror.
But not the one from King's Quest, because we saw her in it.
That's true. No, it's the one from Black Cauldron that we never used.
Oh, there you
go. We've got to go get it from the other game.
Oh, no.
Ungefährlich Dinge means dangerous things, according to Google Translate.
Ooh. I do enjoy dangerous things.
Is it true that a monster can't hurt you if you're carrying a torch?
No?
Actually, it depends on how fast you carry it. No!
He's not one of the hecklers. Unless he is. Which in which case he is.
No control over my life. That's why it says if you click your mouth on yourself, he just mumbles about how he has no control over his life. Because I control it! Anyway.
Many types of magic mirrors. One of the more common types is the one that has a strange face popping up every so often.
Reminds me of the one in the master bedroom.
That's not magical.
No, it does have a strange face peering it from whenever you're in the room.
Oh! I'm going to kill you in your sleep, Fenris. At any rate, I used to have a nice magic hand mirror I misplaced. It could be used to reflect a spell back at Connie.
So if you haven't become this crowd, magic mirror has a dragon handle on it.
It was the flagon with the dragon. The mirror had a leer.
Ooh, court jester reference.
Ooh, that's right. We found a magic mirror with a face on it.
It reflects spells. That's basically all you get from Erasmus, a little bit of information. Once again, if you're a mage, he gives you more. But we're not, so goodbye.
Not in my house, you don't.
Also, he zaps you to the bottom of the mountain.
No. Zap.
Rub stone. Woo, 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 woo. That's the King's Quest transport sound. Anyway, I guess I should start sneaking again.
Yeah.
It still looks ridiculous. Uh-oh, it's a guy! Oh. And as a thief, I'll probably die if I fight him, so... But let's give it a shot. It's a brigand! Looks like one of the brigands. Here we go. Let's kill him.
Okay, remember, so, jab left. You're gonna break your knife on his shield.
Yeah, he keeps tanking. So as you can see, I've got hit points, stamina points, and magic points.
And none of them are doing him any good.
I've gotta run away. I'm sorry. Nope, I'm dead. See, that's the thing with thieves, they suck in a fight unless you train them up on goblins.
Well, at least the good thing about this Sierra game is that there's legitimate reasons that you die. Like, I fight someone and he stabs me.
As opposed to, I walked in the wrong direction and now I
was eaten by a random thing.
By a troll.
No, this time you can only die because of your own incompetence.
Ooh, incompetence.
What?
He's still chasing me, this guy.
But you're sneaking. How can he see you?
That's right, I'm hunched over. I should blend right in. That's okay. Here's a centaur.
What? He'll help me.
It's the girl's dad. I'm Heinrich Ferdefund. I still can't pronounce my own name.
Perfenfreffen.
Ferdefurdybird. Anyway. Hilda's a bright little filly. The gist of this guy is that he's a farmer. I'm not going to read all of his lines. And he grows lots of stuff. He was attacked by brigands once, and...
Then he took an arrow to the knee.
His right leg was broken, but the brigand leader intervened and ordered them not to hurt people from the town and gave him a healing potion. So that was nice of the brigand leader, who has a giant helmet on. It was compassion, unlike what one expects from a brigand. So, are you putting together the clues yet, my good doodler?
Yeah, I'm drawing, man. You play the game.
I already know the story of the game, but they're giving out subtle hints as to the whole deal with the brigands and
if
how
they're subtle.
Related.
I'm not getting them because I'm trying to sketch here, man.
Yeah. Okay, let's...
Although, it is a good game, and chat, you should really pay attention to those clues.
Chat already knows, because the one person who is chatting right now is a one person who requested this game in the first place.
Oh.
And has been giving a bunch of trivia on it, so they already know.
Tor El Cool Guy.
That's correct, question mark?
Thank you, Steven. That's right, first name.
What? You're revealing everything again! Now all of our identities will be stolen by the internet. That's how this works, right?
More bronzer. She needs more bronzer.
Okay, so less. Now that she's not going to kiss us, here's the spell component she needs. She'll pay us for. She needs Aranda's flowers, magic mushrooms, troll beard,
Erogenous and flowers?
Cheetar claws. Claws for alarm. Potato Dude has not figured out the connection yet, so you're not alone. Although he's been paying more attention than you have, because you're just doodling.
That's the point!
I know it's the point!
Thank you, Potate Dude. You're cool.
So... I don't have any of those things. So, mushrooms, flowers, a troll beard, and cheetar claws. The last two you have to get off of a dead troll and a dead cheetar. And as a thief, that's probably not going to happen anytime soon. But what she sells is, if you click money on her, she... Stamina potions, healing potions, mana potions, which are pointless for a thief, and undead potions, which will turn you into a zombie. That's not actually true. It protects you against zombies. Anyway, so I'm going to buy some potions so I don't die.
I'm
going to buy some idiots.
Pretty nice.
What?
Nothing. Nothing.
How much money do I have? I'm going to spend all my money on potions, pretty much. I have 3 silver pieces. All right. Well, that's the end of my money. If only as a thief I could rob somebody or so. Oh. That was weird. Anyway, let's explore some more. What say you, Heinrich Hufschausen?
I don't remember. Not quite entirely sure.
Not entirely sure. Let's actually drink one of these stamina potions.
Oh, I see. Now you want to drink one of the stamina potions.
It's invigorating. It's like a Sobe that I just drank. It's basically this right here. I have a Sobe bottle that says energy on it, and it was the same color as that stamina potion. And
oh,
I just
it must
drank
be the exact same
now
thing.
Now I have got stamina.
Do you?
Stamina is a fun word to say. Say it.
No. I mean, yes. Stamina.
So here's a special screen, because it's got music on it, so it's special. Also, there's a bush. It's one strange bush. What?
Bah! It's the first talking, walking bush.
Nothing curious going on here.
Rumble.
It needs cartoon eyeballs, is what it needs.
So you're anything, sneaking around like an idiot. Stretch. It's sneaking around, but it's got horns.
Well, in order to be sneaking, it needs to be hunched over and holding its hands out in front. That's how you sneak. Doesn't this thing know anything?
I don't
anyway,
think
let's
it does.
Just fight it. Hey, there's a dude behind that tree. There's a goblin. Hey, there's a goblin in that bush. Anyway, let's kill a goblin. So health, stamina, magic, and they've got... When you fight them, it sounds like you're eating. It's like, nom, nom. This is the sound that daggers make. Anyway, he had 5 silver on him. So the point of this screen is every time you come back to the screen, more goblins appear until you're fighting like 8 of them at once, which I'm not skilled enough to do yet, but it's like the training ground for fighters.
Right.
So it's pretty cool. Ah. The Gween Goblin. All right, so here's
ooh,
a fairy
a Cromwell.
Ring.
Or a what? A fairy circle?
Yeah, it's a fairy circle.
Ah, that's mushrooms. Why you said it was full of mushrooms.
Well, it wasn't just from this game. These are the mushrooms that the healer wants, by the way. So if you pick a million of them, then you'll have a bunch of money at the end. My chair is sinking. Don't make the sinking joke again. Anyway, so now I've got, like, how many mushrooms?
What is your
42. That's good
thinking
enough.
About?
You made the joke! Here's a stag. It's having a stag party. Let's follow the stag. Okay, I gotta fix this chair again. Oh, and here's something for you.
Ooh. It's jumping.
The eyes of the forest are watching you. There's something special about this place, because it has a soundtrack. I wonder if we'll be attacked by goblins. This seems like a place for that. Oh, wait, no, it's just a naked tree lady.
What the?
It's the Dryad Keeper of the Woods.
Are you one with the woods?
Oh, she's very dry.
I'm a little parched. Perhaps I could use a stamina potion.
Were you one with the woods? Sure, why not?
Then you shall aid me, and I shall aid you in your quest.
Dryad.
So hard to stay warm. Bring me a seed from the spore-spitting spiry of the north, that I may plant it elsewhere in order to preserve this blah, 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 whatever.
All right.
You obviously care a lot about these characters.
I don't care